mysterious and spooky. They're all together ooky, the Addams Family. The house is a museum. When people come to see them, they really are a scream, the Addams Family.
Neat. Sweet. Petite.
So get a witch's shawl on, a broomstick you can crawl on. We're gonna pay a call on the Addams Family.
What's up, fellow movie buffs and film connoisseurs? It's your self-proclaimed cinema shogun here. And on today's episode of The Dirty Laundries, Chris and Roberta take a nice little trip to Walmart. That is right. For the first time since we've been paying attention to this investigation, Chris and Roberta have the confidence to go out shopping. They went out to Walmart today, walked around the store quietly, had a nice little shopping visit. Then afterwards, I believe they went to, was it FedEx? And then they stopped by their favorite place to get burner phones, AT&T. They made sure to stop by there before they went home. And then they went home, but it's kind of weird to me. Seeing as they haven't really left the house this whole entire time, and now they're starting to feel comfortable enough to go out, live their life, and do their thing. Now, everyone has a right to go out and live your life and do your thing. But the timing is odd, seeing as it looks like a lot of the search has been called off. And you see all this stuff still happening in front of their home. We know Chris is getting sued over $40. He just installed security cameras. He just hit some of the protesters with trespassing warnings. And they're fighting back. They're fighting back.
Is your son still alive? Have you been in contact with him? Where do you think he is? Is he really in that park? Did he really go to the park? Did you help him get to the park or out of the park?
So as the media slows down the coverage of the Petito case, slowly but surely, out crawl the Laundries from out of their little hole. And from now on, you're gonna see the Laundries going out and doing more and doing more. Because they're pretty confident that their son got away. They know that he's not in that reserve. And even if they thought for one second that he was, they know that the police aren't finding him now. And in fact, I'll take it one step further. I think they're confident that the buzz around this case is starting to die down. If things were as crazy as they were a couple weeks ago, and as many eyes were on this case as there was a couple of weeks ago, Chris and Roberta wouldn't be at Walmart. Chris and Roberta wouldn't be going to all these random stores, just acting like nothing's going on. And the fact that they could walk through that Walmart, get all their shopping done, and no one recorded them, no one bothered them, only someone caught them on a cell phone camera once they came outside, the fact that they went in there and did all that lets you know that a lot of people don't know about this case. I'll go so far as to say about 99.9% of the people they passed by in that Walmart had no idea who those people were. They're just regular old people shopping around at Walmart. Because not as much people know about this case as we think. This case has all of us entangled, and we're all raveled up in this case. And it's easy to assume that everyone in the world knows about this case and everyone's worried about justice for Gabby. But that's honestly not the case. And the fact that they could go out there and shop at Walmart with no one harassing them or bothering them should show you that that's the case. Not only are they out there shopping at Walmart and doing whatever without anyone bothering them, they're literally like 5 or 10 minutes away from home where everyone should know about this case. But no, half the people don't. Or else you better believe they wouldn't have made it out of that Walmart with that stuff without at least being on hella videos, Snapchats and TikToks and what have you. So it looks like to me that the Laundries are going to start trying to go back to business as usual. And at the same time, a lot of the media is starting to disappear from in front of their house. So they're feeling confident now. And it's kind of scary when you think about it. Like, don't get me wrong. People can do, I'm not saying that they shouldn't be able to live their lives at all, but it's kind of scary when you think about the fact that, who knows, a few weeks, a few months from now, Chris and Roberta Laundry will go back to life as normal. Going and repairing juice machines, whatever the hell they do, making ponchos. Going and filling up their gas tanks and going to the store, going to eat at Applebee's, 2 for $25? All that stuff. And everything will be swept under the rug and a new story will arise. And Brian will be out somewhere living his best life. That's what I'm worried about. And those are the feelings that come to my mind when I see these people out here going back to business as usual. And like I said, I'm not saying that people shouldn't be allowed to live their lives and people shouldn't be allowed to go to Walmart, things like that, but just the fact that they haven't been doing this the whole time. Now, if they were doing this the whole time, then this wouldn't stick out to me. I wouldn't say anything about it. But this is the first time that we've seen them. Like, they're going out there and they're getting their own stuff now. Because they know that the story is dying down. That the momentum behind this Justice for Gabby Petito movement and the momentum behind finding their son is dialing back. And if you can't tell, I can tell. And if we can tell, how do you think they feel? When they peek out their window and they notice, like, oh, well, honey, Roberta, honey, there's about 3 less cameramen outside today. Then they look to the left. Oh, I don't see Brian in. And then they peek out the other side. Oh, there's no random Karens outside screaming and yelling with bullhorns. And they know. Well, it's about time to start going back to usual. Brian's long gone. Brian is long gone. So I know a lot of people are going to read really deeply into the fact that they stopped at this FedEx place and they stopped at the AT&T store. But I don't know if we should read into that too deeply, but it does raise a few questions. Because, I mean, in today's day and age, don't we all basically pay our cell phone bill online or just come straight off of out of our you know, bank account? Who really goes and physically pays their phone bill? Not many people. I think that's safe to assume. So what are Roberta and Chris Laundry going to AT&T for? Do they feel like they need new phones again? Maybe a nice new little iPad so they could watch my YouTube videos and talk shit about me. Who knows? But they went there. And it's kind of weird because I'm just wondering, like, what business do you have at this AT&T store? Are you trying to buy new devices because you don't trust your old devices? Is that what it is? I mean, who in the hell in their right mind is even talking to you all on the phone right now? Are y'all still getting phone calls and text messages from people? I highly doubt it. But I want to know your thoughts about all of this down in the comments below. Do you think that the Laundries are getting a little bold and they think that it's time they could crawl out from under their rock and just go back to business as usual? Or do you think we shouldn't read too much into this? Let me know down in the comments below. While you're down there, hit that thumbs up button. Hit that subscribe button. Ring that notification bell. Go to the description of this video. I will leave a link to my Twitter. You can follow me on there. Contact me there. If you want to support the channel, my Cash App will be in the description as well. You can support me that way. And as always, find some time out of your day to go watch a movie.